Welcome to the DJI Terra tutorial video, where we'll guide you through using LiDAR point cloud mission with Zenmuse L3. DJI Terra supports post-processing of data collected by Zenmuse L3 to reconstruct point clouds, 2D maps, 3D mesh models, Gaussian splatting, DMs, and contours. It also allows you to define an ROI to determine the reconstruction area and setting block parameters to define the size of point cloud file blocks. Cluster processing for high-volume point cloud data is also supported. Enter DJI Terra and click Create Project. Select LiDAR Point Cloud. Set the project name and storage location. Click Select Folder and Import Data. Click POS calculation settings to select data POS, local PPK, or cloud PPK. When using DJI DRTK3 as the base station, we suggest using local PPK. Click local PPK, add the base station file, select DJI DRTK, and import your DRTK3 files. Once selected, click start calculation for the most accurate point cloud trajectory. After calculation, click Flight Trajectory Clipping and Polygon Selection. Left-click to add polygon points and quickly select the desired trajectory. Click the top right delete button or press the delete key on the keyboard to quickly delete the trajectory. You can also use single selection for quick deletion or use the delete button in the outline tree on the right to quickly delete a single trajectory. Trajectory clipping supports undo. Click Save after editing. Clipped flight trajectories will not be included in the reconstruction process. Click Basic Parameters, select Standalone Computation as the computation method, and the point cloud reconstruction mission will only be performed locally. Select Cluster Computation to utilize multiple computers on a local area network to reconstruct the same task. When using Zenmuse L3 with DJI Matrice 400, you can collect up to 100 square kilometers of data in a single day. DJI Terra cluster computation overcomes the data limitations of a single computer, allowing you to efficiently process these large point cloud datasets and greatly boost reconstruction speed for very large projects. Go to scene to choose point cloud processing or substation. Set up control and checkpoints according as needed. Adjust the horizontal and vertical datum settings. Ground control points can be entered manually or imported from a file. Click ROI/block. ROI setup method can be set to adjust manually. You can set ROI for reconstruction by choosing the default range, the maximum range, or by importing custom ranges via KML files. After settings, only the output within the ROI will be reconstructed, and outputs outside the ROI will not be generated. Block splitting settings are supported, with automatic block splitting enabled by default. Supports custom block memory and custom block edge length. Auto and custom block memory will tile the point cloud based on the computer memory, resulting in irregular block sizes. To generate regular blocks, use the custom block side length function. Custom block side length function allows you to set the block side length, corresponding coordinate system, and origin for neatly divided reconstruction data boundaries. After setting block parameters, click Calculate and Preview to quickly view the block boundaries. When setting ROI setup method to select block, to select the blocks to be reconstructed by clicking on them. Unselected blocks will not be reconstructed, which better supports local updates and replacement for large datasets. After setting the ROI and blocks, click Save and Apply. The reconstruction will use the Save ROI and block settings. The point cloud density can be adjusted based on percentage or distance. Choose the desired point cloud output. DJI Terra supports formats such as PNTS, LOS, PLY, PCD, S3MB, and LAZ. Enable merge output, and the point cloud results will be merged into a single file. This can be selected before or after reconstruction. Enable ground point classification. The software filters out buildings, vegetation, and other objects, leaving only the ground points. This classified ground point data is ideal for generating DMs and contours. DJI Terra can use data from the Zenmuse L3 to generate Gaussian splatting models. For quality settings, you can choose from extra high, high, or preview. High mode delivers solid output, while extra high mode offers greater clarity but significantly increases reconstruction time. Preview mode is only for quickly verifying whether the data can be used for reconstruction and provides a basic preview to check if the materials meet the requirements for reconstruction. Click Start Reconstruction. After reconstruction is complete, open the task to view the LiDAR output. Thank you for watching.